Morisate. Welcome to Greek Heritage Day. Welcome to Brockton City Hall. It's our pleasure to celebrate Greek independence today with all of our friends here in the Greek community. I would like to open today's ceremonies by asking Father Anthony for the invocation.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Lord our God, we bow down to you in worship, having celebrated recently the incarnation of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ as he becomes man through the flesh of the Holy Virgin Mary, as announced to her by the Archangel Gabriel. We also offer thanksgiving as we celebrate the independence of the Greek nation from the oppressive yoke of the Ottoman Turks. Through both of these events, we have gained freedom. In the one case, freedom from the bondage of sin and death, and in the other, freedom from human oppressors. We pray that the significance of these two events continue to touch our hearts and souls for the better, and that we become beacons of faith and democracy to all those to whom we cross paths in this life. Our world today is plagued with acts of evil and violence. Only through your guidance can we find the faith and strength within us to oppose these acts on all levels, always remembering the freedom we have been given through the incarnation of your Son and through those who struggled for freedom from human oppression in Greece, in the United States, and in all democratic societies around the globe. Amen.
Thank you, Father. If we could all remain standing at this time, we would like to invite up Alexis and Karina Katsopoulos. Katsopoulos. I did it great in practice. Katsopoulos. Alexis and Karina.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave?
We have several elected officials here with us today. I want to make sure that we recognize City Councilor Shirley Asak is here. Shirley. I think Councilor Lally, is Councilor Lally here? City Councilor Jack Lally in the back. Senator Mike Brady is here, as always. And Representative Claire Cronin is en route from the State House. She's stuck in traffic, but she is en route, will be here shortly. State Rep Jerry Cassidy is in a House Ways and Means Committee hearing and is unable to leave the State House. Well, it's a great pleasure to see so many of my friends from the Greek American community here today as we celebrate Greek Independence Day. For 400 years, the Greek people were slaves and oppressed by the Ottoman Empire. But 196 years ago, March 25th, 1821, Bishop Yermanos of Patras raised the Greek flag at his monastery, which started the War of Greek Independence. The cry, freedom or death. Zoe e Thanatos became the motto of the revolution. Since 1821, the flag of Greece has had a white cross on the upper right-hand corner, covering a quarter of the flag, signifying the important role of the Greek Orthodox Church in the formation of the Hellenic nation. The blue and white alternating stripes represent the sea and relentless waves of the Aegean. The nine stripes represent each syllable of the words, freedom or death. Today we also celebrate what Greece has contributed since its ancient days. The glorious Parthenon still stands as a symbol of beauty and architectural perfection. And throughout the world, buildings are modeled with Greek design, including our own American capital in Washington, D.C. So much of Western civilization owes its basic concepts of law, math, medicine, art, theater, and even warfare to the ancient Greeks. And also much of the English language is derived from the Greek language, from Greek words. So we certainly have much to celebrate here today. Kalitera mia ora eleftheri zoe para saranda ronia sklavia ke filiki. I did better on that than the girls' names, anyhow. First, we have a couple of distinguished guests to make some remarks here today as we celebrate Greek independence. And first, I'd like to invite up the Vice President of the Parish Council of the Greek Orthodox Church, Mr. George Panagopoulos.
You're talking off of my...
Sorry.
That's okay.
Stole some e-material.
Honorable Mayor Bill Carpenter, Honorable State Senator Michael Brady, Reverend Father Anthony Evangelatos, Honorable Guests, Ladies and Gentlemen, Zito Yelas. We're here today to celebrate March 25th of 1821, to mark the beginning of the Greek Revolution. Greece is a country where democracy was born. Greece is a country where the science and dialogue were found. Greece is a country where language were used to cultivate thinking, a country where the Olympic Games were found. The Greek language became the international language and the language where the New Testament was written. We, as Americans of Greek descent, are proud to our heritage, and we're proud of our contribution to this country, the United States of America, for our contributions to the state of Massachusetts, and the contributions of our great city of Brockton. On March 25th, 1821, messenger from God, Archangel Gabriel, told Theotokos that would deliver Jesus. The same time, it was chosen by the Greeks to start the Greek Revolution and the liberation of Greece from the occupation of the Turkish Ottoman Empire. On March 25th, 1821, a small group of rebels took the arms to fight for the liberation of Greece. Freedom or death was their slogan, and motivated the Greeks to fight the Ottoman Empire. In places like Kalavrita, Kalamata, Patra, Thessaloniki, Lala, Tripoli, and elsewhere on land and the sea, the Greeks fought with the weapons they got from their previous battles. They fought for their children, for their religion, for their freedom. The Ottoman occupation of Greece lasted 400 years, four centuries, which many other nations lost their identity a few years of occupation, but not the Greeks. The values of human rights, the values of family, kept the spark lit, and the fire erupted on March 25th, 1821. The nations of the world learn about the Greek Revolution, and many bring this matter to their government and ask for help. Governor Webster of Massachusetts was among them, one of them. Lord Byron from England put all his property for the Greek Revolution and went to Greece to fight the Turks. Dr. Samuel Hoe from Boston went to Greece to help the wounded and many other Philhellenists. Today, we the Greeks, we're the America on the United States of America. Here in Brockton, Massachusetts, we're proud of our heritage, our history, and the contribution to our society. We will continue our journey as American citizens of Greek descent, and we're proud. We're part of this country, a mosaic of nations, and we should continue to convey to our children and grandchildren these values for better society. We should introduce to our neighbors and friends these values. The first Greek immigrants did not speak the English language, but today our children and grandchildren flourish in many areas like business, academia, medicine, and politics. Together with our continued efforts, and we improve ourselves for a we can improve ourselves for a better future. Thank you all. Zito Elas. God bless America. Αξιότιμη κύριε Δήμαρχε, Bill Carpenter, αξιότιμη State Senator, Michael Brady, Πάτερ Αντώνια, εκλεκτή προσκεκλημένη, κυρίες και κύριοι και αγαπημένα μας παιδιά. Σήμερα βρισκόμαστε εδώ στο, στο κέντρο να εορτάσουμε μια μεγάλη στιγμή της ιστορίας της Ελλάδας, της χώρας που γέννησε τη δημοκρατία και πολλές τέχνες, της χώρας που ανέπτυξε τη σκέψη, τη χώρα που γέννησε τους Ολυμπιακούς Αγώνες, της χώρας που η γλώσσα της έγινε παγκόσμια, στην οποία γράφει και το Ευαγγέλιο. Σαν σήμερα ο Αρχάγγελος Γαβριήλ έδωσε στην Παναγία το μήνυμα ότι θα φέρει στον κόσμο τον Μεσσία. Είναι η μέρα που οι Έλληνες σήκωσαν τα άρματα και τα έβαλαν με την Οθωμανική Αυτοκρατορία. Την 25η Μαρτίου του 1821, μια χούφτα αμαρτωλή ξεσηκώθηκαν και άρχισαν την επανάσταση με την οποία απελευθερώθηκε η Ελλάδα. Το σύνθημα ήταν ένα, ελευθεριά ή θάνατος. Και με, το θούριο του Ρίγα Φεραίου, ως πότε παλικάρια, θα ζούμε στα στενά, μονάχοι σαν λιοντάρια, στις ράχες, στα βουνά. Καλύτερα μιας ώρας ελεύθερη ζωή, παρά 40 χρόνια σκλαβιά και φυλακή. Στα Καλάβρητα, την Καλαμάτα, την Πάτρα, τα Δερβανάκια, το Λάλα, στην Τρίπολη και αλλού, στα βουνά και στη θάλασσα, οι Έλληνες νικούν και πολεμούν με τα όπλα που παίρνουν από τους Τούρκους, οι οποίοι αρκετοί από αυτούς σκοτώθηκαν, ενώ άλλοι πολλοί τα έβαλαν στα πόδια. Για του Χριστού την πίστη, την Αγία και της πατρίδας, την ελευθερία. Ο αγώνας ήταν άνισος, γιατί οι Τούρκοι είχαν οργανωμένο στρατό και πολυάριθμο, ενώ οι Έλληνες ήταν λίγοι και χωρίς όπλα. Σε κάθε μάχη όμως, με τις νίκες τους έπαιρναν τα λάφυρα, για λάφυρα τα όπλα των Τούρκων. Κέρδισαν οι Έλληνες γιατί πολεμούσαν για την οικογένεια, τη θρησκεία, την πατρίδα, που ήταν υπόδουλη στους Τούρκους για 400 και πλέον χρόνια. Άλλοι λαοί σβήνουν μέσα σε τόσα χρόνια σκλαβιάς, όχι όμως ο ελληνικός λαός, γιατί πολέμησε για τα ιδανικά της φυλής. Οι λαοί της γης διαβάζουν τις εφημερίδες της εποχής για την ανδρεία των Ελλήνων, ενώ πολλοί φιλέλληνες, όπως κυβερνήτης Webster της Μασαχουσέτης, ο Λόρδος Βάιρον, ο Δόκτωρ Σάμιουελ από τον Μπόστον και πολλοί άλλοι που ξεσήκωσαν τον κόσμο υπέρ της μικρής αλλά ένδοξης χώρας που έδωσε στον κόσμο τα φώτα του και τον πολιτισμό. Εμείς οι νεότεροι Έλληνες εδώ στην Αμερική, στο Μπρόκτον, είμαστε περήφανοι για την καταγωγή μας και τον πολιτισμό μας. Πρέπει όμως να μεταλαμπαδεύσουμε στα παιδιά μας και τα εγγόνια μας, στους φίλους μας που δεν είναι Έλληνες. Πρέπει να μεταλαμπαδεύσουμε, λέω, την ελληνική γλώσσα, την ορθόδοξη πίστη, τα ήθη και τα έθιμα. Ζούμε ελεύθεροι στη μεγάλη αυτή χώρα των Ηνωμένων Πολιτειών, τη δεύτερη πατρίδα μας, και είμαστε περήφανοι, αλλά έχουμε καθήκον ιερό. Ο καθένας ή η κάθε μία από μας πρέπει να εργαστούμε πιο πολύ από τους πρωτοπόρους Έλληνες. Δεν πρέπει να επαναπαυόμαστε, γιατί οι καιροί είναι δύσκολοι και την Εκκλησία, το ελληνικό σχολείο σιγά σιγά τα ξεχνάμε. Δεν πρέπει να μιλάμε μόνο για την ιστορία μας, αλλά πρέπει να μιλάμε για το σήμερα και για το μέλλον του ελληνισμού στον Μπρόκτον και στην όλη την Αμερική. Έχουμε ευθύνη όλοι για αυτό που είμαστε και που πάμε. Θα πάμε μπροστά ενωμένοι, με υλοποιημένους στόχους, με συνεργασία και με τη βοήθεια του Θεού. Σας ευχαριστώ. Ζήτω η Ελλάδα!
So I'm pleased to announce that State Representative Clea Cronin has joined us, just arriving from the State House. Representative, great to have you here. Thank you for making the effort to get here. I know it was not easy. We'll have some remarks on behalf of the entire state legislative delegation made by State Senator Mike Bradyopoulos.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, and thank you for everyone coming out today. I know the weather's not too good, so we had to move the event inside, but it's good to see so many friends. You are family to us in the city of Brockton. And I'm going to try to keep my remarks brief, because Arthur Kalliyoios is waiting for us at the new Cafe G of the Pan Macedonian Club. He's got food being prepared for us. But I have to say, we've got to get a round of applause to Representative Claire Cronin. She just became chairman of Judiciary, the first woman in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts to be chairperson of Judiciary. And as was mentioned, Representative Jerry Cassidy, he just got appointed to the Ways and Means Committee, which is very important. He is working very, very diligently to try to get money for the city of Brockton. And the Ways and Means Committee is one of the most important committees as well in the State House. And he's at a hearing because he would love to be here. Because as we all know, we all grew up within the Greek community in Brockton. We could never give back from our heart for your friendship and your commitment to the city of Brockton, never mind the political support. We have so many great memories of growing up in the old neighborhoods with the Cape Cod Cafe. Thank you to Mr. Jamoulis here, the BC, the Parkway, all the great memories, Phillips Luncheonette. We have so many Christos, who was dear to our heart. And of course, Louis the Tailor, who, when I started putting the weight on, he would say to me, Blady, pretty soon you're going to need suspenders. So I got to lose some weight, but we miss him greatly. I know also Yanni Calanzas would be here, but he's busy taking care of all of our taxes, because I know he does all of our taxes in this room today. But we are forever grateful for your support and your contribution, not only to the city of Brockton, but to the United States of America. So, zito alas.
Okay, at this time I would like to issue a proclamation on behalf of the city of Brockton, and then immediately following the proclamation, we'll have the young ladies come back up and sing the Greek national anthem as we raise the Greek flag. So first, let me read the proclamation. Whereas Greece declared independence from the Ottoman Empire on March 25, 1821, in an act that demonstrated the resolute spirit that has characterized Greek culture through the ages. And whereas the birth of democracy in Greece ushered in a golden age of Western civilization, creating a culture that valued human liberty and dignity, principles that have inspired American democracy to this day. And whereas the friendship between our two nations flows from our shared values, common goals, and mutual respect, and our alliance has remained strong through decades of challenge and change. And whereas the city of Brockton has been greatly enriched by the introduction of Greek customs, religion, and culture, which were brought to us by the Greek immigrants who made the way to our city and made an indelible mark on the city of champions. And whereas it is an honor to recognize the accomplishments and contributions of our citizens of Greek ancestry and to extend to them best wishes for continued success and prosperity. Now therefore be it resolved, I, Bill Carpenter, as mayor of the city of Brockton, do hereby proclaim today, March 27th, 2017, as Greek Heritage Day. And I urge all residents of the city to join me in observing this day and recognizing all the wonderful contributions the Greek culture and Greek community has made to our city. And this is signed and sealed today, the 27th day of March. Zito e ekosti pemti martio, zito e elas efaristo.
Zito.
Do you want Father Anthony and George? I'll present the actual proclamation to you. It's my pleasure to present to George and to Father Anthony the actual proclamation. There you
go. Se gnorizo po την κόψη του σπαθιού την τρομερή. Σε γνωρίζω από την όψη που με βιά μετράει την γη. Απ' τα κόκαλα βασμένη των Ελλήνων τα ιερά και σαν πρώτα αντριωμένη χαίρε, χαίρε ελευθερία.
Yes, I am.